But anyway, let's get across today's market moves with Ed Boyd. And Ed, it was all about those metallurgical coal producers today.
It was, Ross. Any company that produces coal for steelmaking did really well. We'll get to them in just a second. But first, overall market slumped 0.7% at the open this morning after a weak lead from Wall Street over the weekend. Tech stocks and healthcare companies dropped. Miners and property REITs lifted. The market bounced back a bit, finished the day down 0.22%. Now, here's a look at those met coal producers who jumped after Anglo American announced that it had suspended production at its Grosvenor coal mine in Queensland due to an underground fire. No one was injured, but it could take several months before the mine is back up and running. And it produces about 30% of Anglo's Queensland coking coal. So coal supply will be restricted for a while. That's obviously helped these Aussie coal producers, especially Coronado, up almost 8.9%. Other tops included lithium miner IGO, rare earths miner Lynas, and real estate investor Cromwell Property Group was the best performing REIT, up 2.56%. Tex-Mex food retailer Guzman & Gomez was one of the worst performers today. There was no announcement from them, but we know short sellers are circling. Logistics software maker WiseTech Global slumped after its CEO Richard White sold about $140 million worth of shares last month. And private hospital operator Healius was the worst health stock, down 4.3%. And over the weekend, the value of the euro it rose against the Aussie dollar after the French far-right party led by Marine Le Pen was poised to win the first round of France's legislative election with a slightly smaller margin than expected. Aussie dollar currently buying just under 62 euro cents. And Ross, that's markets.
Thanks so much, Ed.